Welcome to Webflow, the website experience platform where designers, marketers, and developers come together to design, build, optimize, and scale powerful websites. And you might be thinking, that sounds familiar, because it is. But in this video, we're going to explain how Webflow works behind the scenes, how it creates the code for you as you build your sites visually. And we'll do that by talking about the foundation the web is built on and how it relates to Webflow. We'll break it down into five chapters. First, the box model. We'll then see real examples of HTML, CSS, and JavaScript on the web and in Webflow. And finally, we'll put it all together. First, the box model. The web, all of it, is built on the box model. Every single thing you see, all the content, the structure, are made of boxes. There are three key things to keep in mind. The first is, these boxes stack on top of each other or next to each other based on the properties we set. Second, they behave like a text document. Things start at the top left and they can even wrap when they hit the ads. But content on the web can reflow, and the box model lets us clearly define how these things respond, how they wrap, how they reflow based on the space available. And third, we actually have full control over the properties of these boxes. But why is this important? Because that's exactly what we're doing when we build in Webflow. Here on the canvas, we have a simple layout. We have a section, a container, and a few div blocks with some content inside. And as we click on these and move them around, we're seeing the box model in action. That's the box model. Let's talk about the HTML, the structure and the elements. HTML is one of the most important foundations of the web. It's the basic structure, the boxes of content on the page, just like we saw earlier. In Webflow, we have our HTML, our elements, here in the Add Elements panel. And we have a lot of options here. A button, a heading, a paragraph, a form, all sorts of elements. And if we go in and add a heading to our site, and we just click in and type something here, and actually let's make this an H2, now we have another HTML element on our site. We can confirm that by going up here in our global menu, and we'll look into the export code option. And while this is loading, I'm going to tell you a little personal story. So this morning, it's done. And if we look in here a little closer, we can see the section, the container, our div blocks, and our heading here, our H2. This is our HTML, and this code writes itself as we create visually on the canvas. That's how the HTML works in Webflow. Let's look at the CSS. First off, CSS is how we define the styling and layout of our HTML elements. It enables us to keep things even and consistent across the site. Here in Webflow, we access our CSS controls in the style panel. There are numerous properties we can manipulate here, but let's just change the font. We can choose whatever we want. We'll just make it a little bigger and we'll choose a color. Let's make it a little lighter here. And the same thing is happening here in our CSS preview. We can see the code writing itself in real time. So what just happened? We styled our HTML by using CSS, which, by the way, stands for Cascading Style Sheets. And the important thing here is that it lets us set these kind of properties on pretty much anything. But this is just the start of CSS. So much more to learn and explore. Let's move on to JavaScript, the interactions part of Webflow. If you ever browse the web, it's more than likely that you've seen or experienced interactions on a site. But what is an interaction? For example, if we scroll through the page, then these elements change position. Or if we click on this button, it triggers this to happen. Or as we scroll, this element scales along the x-axis. Those are interactions. JavaScript is the web language that makes up most of these interactions. And when we go back to Webflow, to our interactions panel, we can build out our interactions quickly and in a visual way. But why is this so valuable? Because instead of you needing to know complex JavaScript code to build highly advanced animations for your site, Webflow allows you to make beautiful, engaging interactions for the web, visually. And for developers who do know JavaScript, like Keegan, Webflow can help you create interactions quickly and visually. Again, there is so much more to learn and explore when it comes to interactions. So that's how it all comes together in Webflow. At the core, we're using the box model. Then we add our HTML elements to build out the site. We use CSS to define styling and layout. And lastly, we can use interactions, JavaScript, to create triggers and animations to make the site even more interactive and engaging. And on top of these core foundations, there's so much more to learn when it comes to building in Webflow. For example, building out layouts and designs using variables, components, and libraries. These structures help you and your team build on-brand, consistent experiences within a system. And you can use all these building blocks within Webflow while the code is created for you. So you don't necessarily need to know how to code to build in Webflow, but understanding what's happening behind the scenes can and will help you make decisions about how you're building and structuring your site. Okay, that's a high-level overview of how Webflow works.